to me before you do them? Are you trying to get a rise out of me? Are you happy now? Is this what you want?
Oh, no, it's not what I want. It's not what I want. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
It's never been this bad before. What do we do?
What we always do.
I'm in charge of my head. That much I know.
What the hell are you doing on my property?
Look, it's time we bury the hatchet. So I brought a bottle of your favorite booze. Now let's just have a drink and put this all behind us.
I don't want nothing from you.
Hold on, I got something else. Cigars! We can smoke them together, all happy, like a bunch of douchebags outside a wedding.
Peter, get out of here. I'm never gonna forgive you for what you did.
Oh, come on. This'll change your mind.
Oh, my God! Quick, do something! It's not working! Get rid of it!
Get out now!
See, kids, I told you we'd make friends here. I guess me getting transferred by the Xerox Corporation wasn't the worst thing after all.
Oh, thank God, Joe. Are you here to give me the deposit for the shirts?
No, Peter. I'm here to place you under arrest for the attempted murder of Cleveland Jr.
What are you talking about? You know it was an accident.
Yeah, but let's just say public opinion has shifted. And the boys upstairs said they can no longer ignore it.
Who the hell are the boys upstairs?
I have no idea. There's no elevator. But whoever they are, they're pretty steamed about this whole thing.
Peter, what's going on?
They're taking me to jail!
Oh, my God!
Don't worry, Dad. I'll send you a cake with a file in it.
These are just the owner manuals for all our kitchen appliances. Well, guess I finally have time to learn to reset the clock on the coffee maker.
He never did.
You're not gonna rape me, are you?
Of course I'm not gonna rape you. I'm gonna make you fall in love with me. Then, we'll see what happens.
Oh, no. It's already working.
Griffin, you have a visitor?
Carter? What are you doing here?
Hello, Griffin. I'd like to talk to you about these charges that have been brought against you. Why don't we go somewhere a little more private?
I guess I'll see you in a little bit.
It's gonna feel like an eternity.
How is it that I'm only just now meeting you? Look, Carter, you gotta believe me. I didn't shoot Cleveland Jr. because he was black.
Hey, you don't have to tell me that. But the media's out there making you look like a monster. All for exercising your constitutional rights.
Grover's a monster.
But don't worry. We're gonna get you out of this. I'll be damned if I'm gonna sit back and let them do this to one of my own.
What, you mean your family?
Huh? Oh, yeah, that. Yeah, right. Look, I'm gonna bail you out of here, set you up with my lawyer, and get these charges dropped.
Well, how are you gonna do that?
Don't worry, I'll come up with a good story and they'll eat it up. Not like when I read my JAG fan fiction at the NCIS convention. JAG stood up and yelled, "Objection, Your Honor, by Navy law!" He then turned to the lady lawyer, the gal from the October Maxim, who still managed to be hot despite her sexless pageboy haircut. Or perhaps because of it.
Boo!
Terrible!
Right branch of the military, wrong investigative arm!
And I was trying to get back into my house, and my neighbor, Mr. Griffin, shot me! He said he felt threatened by me, and that hurt even worse than getting shot!
Your Honor, permission to hug the witness?
Granted.
Don't worry, Mr. Griffin. You're every bit as sympathetic as this chubby-cheeked Coco Angel.
I haven't been listening. What's going on?
I don't think it's lost on any of us that the laws are written on white paper.
Yeah, white paper. Check your jacket pocket.
I don't think it's lost on any of us that the laws are written on white paper. Hey, look, I'm just saying, it's no surprise that justice isn't colorblind.
Check your other jacket pocket.
Hey, look, I'm just saying it's no surprise that justice isn't colorblind. Stewie, you're a jerk.
Check Chris's pocket.
What, there's nothing in here, and... Oh, God, the bottom of the pocket's been cut out!
Thanks, Brian. I was the mastermind behind this whole thing.
Your witness.
All right, watch this. This is where we take control of the situation.
Mr. Brown, you testify that you were listening to music at the time of the shooting.
That's right.
And isn't Jay-Z music?
Yes.
And doesn't he have the lyrics, "I put the gun to you, I'll kill ya, I'll chop ya up, put ya inside the mattress like drug money"?
Well, I was listening to Neil Sedaka's Hanukkah album.
And isn't it true that your last name is the same as Chris Brown's?
Yes, but I don't see
what did Chris Brown do to Rihanna?
He hit her. like 100 times.
Your Honor, I'd like to enter into evidence this photo of a badly beaten Rihanna, as well as this print ad for the Entourage movie.
Why?
I can't unsee this.
Who is this for?
What's he doing? He's making Cleveland Jr. look like a thug.
I know. That's the idea. You don't want to go back to jail, do you?
I don't know. Maybe.
Mr. Brown, please pick up this knife. Ah! He's got a knife!